Hello friends, I hope you've enjoyed my 3D printable joystick adapters for your gamepads. Before I go into today's topic, here is just an update on the Xbox One. See, now it has two sticks and triggers on both sides, so go and find these. With these two sticks, you can play your favorite Star Wars game. Or your least favorite Star Wars game as well. Masters of Teräskäsi? That's just thinking in Finnish. What are they thinking? Just taking a word from another language thinking no one would notice? Of course you can play my favorite game, Microsoft Flight Simulator, with this as well. And now that you have these thumb buttons and these triggers... Oh no! Oh my god, okay, so a lot of civil aviation airplanes don't have a joystick, a flight stick like this, but this, it's a yoke. So, that's exactly what I made. So let's get rid of this flimsy thing. So I already have a bag full of these printed joysticks. You know, for all different controller types, left and right hand. Look, it's a PlayStation yoke. So as you can see, the controller is on this pivot. Turning it sideways turns the little thumbstick through this linkage, and that's registered as yoke movements in your game. There's this great big slider that goes back and forth, so you can push down and pull up, and this linkage down here is what transmits the force to the other stick. This is actually my first time ever flying yoke. Always flown a stick plane. Then again, it's rare for my yokes to land either. Can we do a loop in a Cessna? Push down to get some speed and then pull up. So let me show you how to print one. Here's the parts you need to print. For clamping it down, you can use this sort of G-clamp that comes from a desk clamp. So it's a desk clamp out of a desk clamp. If you don't have any clamps, don't worry. I'm sure you have a 3D printer, just print some. I've never let the lack of clamps hold me down. To make one of these couldn't be easier. Just print out all these white parts and then the yoke part. It's like cracking an egg. Now you say there's no linear rails or bearings in here, no rods or rollers, it's only these 3D printed parts, so how can you get smooth sliding motion? After all, 3D printed parts are not so smooth, are they? They have rough surfaces, and they can have this grain, so they're not the greatest material to build sliding components out of, are they? However, you can work around them. So a 3D printed part is really made out of these sausages, isn't it? Sausages of plastic laid on top of each other. That's why it's called an SLT file. These form these rough ridges that are really bad at sliding against each other. But what say you line up these ridges of sausages and slide them against each other with the grain? And you can actually get very smooth sliding motion. So check out the slider piece here. So it's got three distinct surfaces. So first the bottom, that's what's against the rough surface of the build plate. So it's dull and frictiony in any direction. Now the top can be quite smooth, but it often develops these ridges around the edge where the lines turn around. The third surface is of course the walls. So check out this side surface. All of these long surfaces are printed so that they're on the wall of the print. So they can get quite smooth and shiny indeed. Can you see the sheen there? So I've designed it so that only these side walls ever slide against each other. And even them, they never slide against their grain, always with their own natural grain. And this way you can get actually very smooth sliding surfaces. With all this scratching and clicking together of plastic parts, someone asked me about my last video if they could use it for an ASMR thing. Of course I gave them my permission, but I'm not sure if the HOTAS joystick is the perfect way to control that game. Furthermore, tolerance is a big thing in a linear array like this. So how do you get good tolerance? What I've done is the floor of this cavity where this slider goes actually has this plate that's printed again so that the wall interacts with the slider. It goes into this little groove here, and this one you can adjust. So if you feel like you've got too much slop, just add a bit of tape or something, or print the whole slate again, a bit thinner this time, or a bit thicker, until you get that perfect fit and tolerance here with this slider. For extra lubrication, just add a little dab of grease. Any grease will work, just some lithium grease, even some Vaseline, tiger balm, olive oil. For my electronics projects, I usually use this brand. And then you can slide in a rubber band here to act as the natural spring for the yoke up and down pitch motion. And the rubber band goes around here so it actually ends up below the device when it's clamped on, and that actually helps keep it in place on your desk. For the rotary motion for your roll, again, this bushing piece is printed so that the walls are the ones interacting with the rotary shaft, which makes the rotation nice and smooth. And again, this is good for tolerance too, because if you find it too loose, you can actually add some tape as padding around this bushing so it actually becomes just that little bit smaller in diameter. That locks down with this dowel. Then you add your controller mount, and there's some dowels for end stops on the roll if you need them. Add an elastic here to get spring tension. And finally you build the linkage. So there's a few linking pieces that you have to make. I think I printed this one too short, but let's just print a new one. I wonder why they, in some planes, go with the yoke design instead of a stick between your feet. Is it because of, you know, just the space and convenience inside your cockpit, because this is more compact? Or is it something related to what I was talking in the Hall Effect joystick video, where it makes sense to have separate controls for pitch and roll instead of having them mixed on one stick? Well, here it's very clear. You're turning your steering wheel is what steers you left and right, and pushing back and forth is the pitch, and there's no mistaking the two. And unlike with a stick, where if you pull back on your joystick, it's very easy to also veer left or right a little bit. Here you can keep them very salient and separate, can't you? This is also good because it leaves your buttons free, so you can actually reach all of them while you're flying. You can use these to control your throttle or your trims, flaps, gears. Oh, and there's even a button to call R2. So this one doesn't have a throttle unit here on your left or your right, but if you have a second controller, why don't you just print one of my throttle units, clip it onto your controller, and put it right next to this. You can have multiple controllers with multiple input. Truly, only the sky is the limit. For the yoke, you could even have it upside down, and then these horns would be your yoke horns. Try that as well. This game, it looks like a PlayStation game, doesn't it? it can look the coolest at some points, but if your computer is not fast enough, it can look horrible too and perform horribly. To be honest, this video might be my final playing this game for a while. It's not been performing greatly. I have a decent computer too, and my internet is pretty fast, but it still took me over a week to update to the latest version. One thing I've come to realize is that this game is actually set in the past. Look, this is the Tsukiji fish market. It's still got all these round buildings with all those little trike trolleys running around selling tuna fish. But this has actually now been demolished and moved away to the island over there. They actually formed a long old line and ran their trolleys all the way to the Toyosu fish market. They built a new one over there. But this must be like 2 or 3 years ago then. So it's actually a historic simulation too. This is nice, they lit up the Rainbow Bridge. Unfortunately, the big towers aren't lit up at all. Many of the buildings that have lights in the night don't have them in this simulation, including Fuji Television over there. But maybe that's a good thing. They started landing from on top of Tokyo towards Haneda here, that airport over there lately. And the approach actually comes on top of this island, that's like a big transport hub. So you can do an approach from here. So how do you like my yoke design? I hope you've enjoyed it. Maybe you can go and download, print one for yourself, snap it onto your controller. Get a little taste of what it might be like to fly a yoke system. What you could also do is only connect the pitch linkage, which is actually the better working one of these two, and have the roll be measured by your accelerometer. See, this controller actually has a little gyro in there, so you can actually measure how much it's tilted. That dot over there is moving when I move the controller. But you can see the reading is very coarse, so it's barely on the edge of usability, I think, I'm afraid. With this app you can also use the RGB lights. Wow. This is turning into a gaming room, isn't it? Yes. Now you too can be a pro gamer. I think we're approaching Shiodome, so let me see if they have my favorite building. It's a super small building, so might not be replicated very well. The building is called the Nakagen Building, and it's so futuristic looking that they used the design in Transport Tycoon, so a lot of people know it as the future building from that game. And there it is, look, you can see it, don't we? Doesn't really retain its shape, but it's got the color at least. I hope you've liked the yoke design. You can download the files, try it out yourself. Print some clamps, get some rubber bands and your PlayStation controller. Until next time, thank you for watching.